So that looks crazy. I think that looks absolutely insane, but I think we could definitely make that look a lot crazier.
Yeah.
What would we have to do to make that fill up a car?
Well, it depends on the car. We'd have to get a dumb little car that was almost perfectly round, like a volumetric flask.
All right.
And then we could, like, turn it into a flask.
I gotcha.
And then we could find out some way to get the catalyst in, and maybe it would work.
Let's do this thing.
We hit the junkyard to give this old car a second life. What it lacks in engine parts, I'll make up for by filling it up with 140 bottles of heavy-duty hydrogen peroxide and 4.5 gallons of dish soap. We're also adding food coloring to give our car a colorful hairdo.
Sorry, dude. You're gonna have to take the brunt of this one.
Then, my slow-mo expert, Darren, loads it up with an obnoxious number of cameras to record the action and show you the science you can't see with the naked eye.
All right, Darren, you wanted a car? We've got a car.
Dude, this looks like Frankenstein gone wrong.
Well, he was the doctor.
I'm really interested in seeing those two dummies in there just getting pasted.
Hey, that's a rude word. They're mannequins. And they're handsome mannequins.
True that.
What's going on, man? What are you planning?
I'll be trying to focus on just the spout.
All right,
hopefully,
cool.
We'll see something dramatic.
All right, man, now's the time. You ready?
Let's do it.
All right. So what we've seen today so far, we call demonstration. So when we're demonstrating a scientific concept, we already know what's gonna happen. There's not really any surprise to it. But this is an experiment. We don't know what's gonna happen. We've never tried this
before. Never done it before?
We don't know that anybody's ever tried it before. So I need some predictions. What do y'all think is gonna happen here?
I think this car's gonna shoot out that way and 60 miles an hour.
60 miles an hour.
And 5 seconds.
I like your ideas, though. Yeah. What other predictions do we have? Anybody else?
Foam is just gonna ooze out of this thing everywhere.
All right, we've got about 140 bottles. That's 70 liters of hydrogen peroxide in the car. We've got our catalyst that's gonna pour down through here. We've got a couple of mannequins inside.
Yeah, who's in there?
Just a couple of dudes.
They look like you.
I guess so.
What are they putting in right now?
So that's our catalyst. That's our potassium iodide, a big bucket full of it. Chris, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, guys. 3, 2, 1. We came to a salon, so we thought we'd give you a nice do for this little car. Yeah, right on.
That was wild.
Darren is using a FLIR thermal cam so we can see all the heat being produced from the chemical reaction. FLIR stands for forward-looking infrared. The camera detects infrared energy, also known as heat. Each color represents different temperatures. In this case, red is the hottest and represents 190 degrees Fahrenheit.
When it shoots up, it's crazy how dramatic the difference is. It looks almost like lava, and it has a very similar way that it kind of folds over. What's even more interesting, though, is that as it comes up, it's looking like it's around 120 degrees, but as it lands around the surrounding area, it's like 190 degrees. It's almost like as it accumulates more and more, like the heat is just trapped in, and it just accumulates to being much hotter temperatures. Looks really cool.
Just like people use foam containers to keep food warm, this foam is insulating the hydrogen peroxide chemical reaction, maintaining its heat. But because the chemical reaction is still happening, the foam gets hotter as it builds.
That was crazy, that was awesome. And the slow motion just looks super good.